interesting class today. Astronomy 101. My name is Professor Lloyd, and I will be your educator today. So, before we begin, I'd like to see a raise of hands. Solar system. And two, do any of you know the names of the planets that are in our solar system? Let's see a raise of hands on how many of you know the answers to these two questions. So, humans have gazed at the heavens and tried to understand the cosmos for thousands of years. Ancient civilizations placed great emphasis on careful astronomical observations. Early Greek astronomers were among the first to leave a written record of their attempts to explain the cosmos. For them, the universe was Earth, the Sun, the Moon, the stars, and five glowing points of light that moved among the stars. The Greeks named the five points of light, called planets, or wanderers, after their gods. The Romans later translated the names into Latin, and they are Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, and Saturn. And these are the names astronomers use today. Planetary features are named by the International Astronomical Union, founded in 1919. Ancient observers believed that the sun and all the other celestial bodies revolved around the Earth. Astronomers gradually realized that the Earth-centered model did not account for the motions of the other planets. In the early 17th century, Galileo Galilei discoveries using the recently invented telescope strongly supported this concept of a... Anyone? Yes, you. That's correct. Solar system in which all the planets, including Earth, revolved around a center star called... Anyone? Yes, you. The sun. Planetary moons. The rings of Saturn and more planets were eventually discovered. Now you're going to need to write this down. Uranus was first discovered in 1781 and Neptune in 1846. The largest known asteroid, called Ceres, was discovered between Mars and Jupiter in 1801. another date that you're going to need to know. Originally classified as a planet, Ceres is now designated as a dwarf planet, but retains its asteroid label, along with another that was long labeled as a planet. Does anyone know the name of this X planet? Yes. Very good. Pluto was once labeled as a normal planet in our solar system, but has now been degraded to a dwarf planet. And this planet, Pluto, was discovered in 1930. Solar system formed roughly around 4.6 billion years ago. That's a very long time. And that's quite a long time. It's quite interesting to think about how long our solar system has been here. Four planets closest to the Sun: Mercury, Venus, Earth, and Mars are called the terrestrial planets. Does anyone know why these four planets are called terrestrial planets? No. Right. It's mainly because they have solid rocky surfaces. Two of of the outer planets beyond the orbit of Mars, which are, anyone? Yes. Correct. Jupiter and Saturn. Now, these two planets are known as, does anyone know? Beautiful planet. And right up above here is the atmosphere all over the globe. Can anyone tell me the two primary components the Earth's atmosphere? Yes. Correct. Nitrogen and oxygen. Other planets don't exactly have the same type of atmosphere as we do. Mars has a very tenuous atmosphere, while Venus has a very thick atmosphere. And let's see a show of hands. Does anyone know what Venus's atmosphere is made of? Yes. Anyone else? You. That's correct. Carbon dioxide, everyone. So, the chances of breathing on Venus are very slim. Mars also has an atmosphere of carbon dioxide. But as I said before, it's a lot thinner than Venus's thick atmosphere. Jupiter and Saturn are mostly made up of, now I know no one will get this, hydrogen and helium. That's right, laughing gas. Breathe in that helium, makes your voice sound ringing. Well, Uranus and Neptune are actually mainly composed of water, ammonia, and methane. Quite a mixture. Now, before we get into the discussion of moons, rings, and magnetic fields, I originally had a slideshow planned, but here at Lloydville University, we're only down to one slide projector and one overhead projector, and unfortunately both of those are in use. So instead I posted the slides up here on the wall for you all to view at your convenience. But let me just show you what we have here. In the first slide, which I don't know if you can see it very well with our lighting system here, but here we have a photo of the solar system. Next, we have a photo of our star, or the sun. Below that, we have a picture of Uranus, followed by us, Earth, and then of course a photo of our moon, which we'll be getting into in the next discussion. Down below, if you can see it, but we have Neptune, and moving over here is a photo of Jupiter, Saturn with its rings. Again, we'll get into that just in a little bit. Then down below we have the dwarf planet of Pluto. You can all come up and see these after class. It tells you quite a bit of information about each planet, as well as down below, it shows you exactly where the location of this planet is from the sun. I also have a book here that I'll be showing you some photos in just a little while, but you'll also be able to come up and take a look at this as well after class. On to moons, rings, and magnetic fields, which are characteristics of the planets. There are 146 known planetary moons. That's a lot of moons. So, this is something you're going to need to write down. Just think of that. 146 moons in our solar system, with 27 of them awaiting recognition, official recognition. The planetary moons are not at all alike. One, which is Saturn's moon, called Titan, has a thick atmosphere. Another, which is Jupiter's moon, has active volcanoes. So just think, all of these moons are like many planets of their own, with their own systems and their own way of being. It's quite interesting. Rings. Rings are an intriguing planetary feature. From 1659 to 1979, Saturn was thought to be the only planet with rings. NASA's Voyager missions to the outer planets showed that Jupiter, Uranus, and Neptune also have ring systems. Most of the planets in our solar system also have something called a magnetic field that extend into space and form a magnetosphere around each planet. These magnetospheres rotate with the planet, sweeping charged particles with them. And then that's why you see all this debris, all these bits and pieces of rock in the rings around Saturn. It's like taking a magnet and you don't see a little magnetic particles that build up on it. It's very similar to that. Now, how big is our solar system? Does anyone know? Okay, well, we're about to learn how big our solar system is, as well as how far each planet is from the sun. How big is our solar system? To think about the large distances, we use a cosmic ruler. Now, this ruler is nothing that you can, pull out of your pocket. This ruler is based on the astronomical unit, or AU. 1 AU is the distance from Earth to the Sun, which is about 150 million kilometers, or 93 million miles away. That is quite a distance. Particles from the sun can reach far beyond the planets, forming a giant bubble. Anyone know? Yes. Sorry. You. Yes. A heliosphere. The enormous bubble of the heliosphere created is created by the solar wind, which is a stream of charged gas blowing outward from the sun. Now, as the sun orbits the center of the Milky Way, the bubble of the heliosphere moves along with it, creating a bow shock ahead of itself in interstellar space. Like the bow of a ship in water, as it crashes into interstellar gases, the region where the solar wind is abruptly slowed by pressure from gas between the stars. Does anyone know what this is called? That's right. It's called termination shock. Now, speaking of distances, let's find out how far each planet is from the sun. Just a fun little activity. So Mercury is 35 million. Need to write this down in your notebooks. It will definitely be on the test. So we have Mercury at 35 million miles away from the sun with zero moons. Venus 67 million miles from the sun, also with zero moons. Earth, us, 92 million miles away from the sun with one moon. Mars, 141 million miles from the sun with two moons. Jupiter, 483 million miles from the sun with a whopping 501 moons. Saturn, 886 million miles from the sun with 531 moons. Uranus, 1,783 million miles from the sun with 27 moons. And Neptune coming in at the farthest from the sun at 2,795 million miles from the sun, almost 3,000 miles from the sun, with 13 moons. So, some interesting facts to think about the next time you look up at the stars. Now I'd like to show you some of the photos of our solar system in this little book I have. Now, I realize some of you may not be able to see these photos from where you're sitting, but like I said, after class, you can come up here and take a look at it yourself. Alright? Alright. Let me get to the page where it talks about the solar system. There it is. So, here we have some photos of Mercury. Let's see if I can show you this one. Here are some photos of Venus. I'm sure you all recognize this planet, Earth. Photos of Mars. Some more photos of the surface of Mars. Some more photos of Jupiter. And here is a photo of Jupiter's rings. We were talking about rings, and here is what Jupiter's rings look like. Almost looks like a rainbow. Here is Saturn. Right there is Saturn's rings. Probably the most famous rings that we've all seen. Uranus, here are some photos of Neptune, and then lastly, the dwarf planet. I will let this up here. are all welcome to come up and look through this book. There's plenty more in here, and we'll be using this book in the future for future classes. So, to finish up, as we explore the universe, we wonder, aren't there other planets where life may exist, like our own, that we've been very fortunate and very lucky to have? Aren't we alone? And not just our solar system, but the universe. Well, these are great questions that science is now probing into day after day, year after year, to find the answers to. I'd like to thank you all for coming and participating in class today, and for overall just being fantastic students. Next time we will start diving deeper into each planet individually. I hope you all have a great rest of your day. Be sure to come up and check the information out that I have here. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask me on the way out. Class is dismissed.